Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you the most common chronic problem is CKD. It's chronic kidney disease, and we can say CRF, chronic renal failure. Definition is, what does it mean by CKD? It's long-term decline or decrease in a renal function measured by GFR. GFR, the G here, glomerular filtration rate. And how to classify this CKD? We are going to classify this CKD in various stages, like stage 1, stage 2, 3A, 3B, 4 and 5th, according to the basis of GFR. Okay, so in first stage 90 to 120 GFR, in second stage is 60 to 189, in 3A it's 45 to 59, 3B is 30 to 44, and 4th is 15 to 29. When the GFR is between 15 and 29, we need to go for RRT. RRT means renal replacement therapy. We need to be ready. But in case of 5th, when GFR is less than 15, we do not have any choice. There is end stage renal disease, ESRD. It's end stage renal disease. And we need to go for transplantation, or we have a choice of dialysis. What was the main cause? First cause of ESRD is diabetes mellitus DM with hypertension. Diabetes mellitus and hypertension chronically causes the most common number one cause of CKD, and second most common cause is infection. Infection is the second most common cause of CKD. So what are the symptoms, and when we need the dialysis in case of CKD? We need dialysis. You have to remember one mnemonic, like A-E-I-O-U, vowels you need to remember. So A, acidemia, or we can say anemia. There is decrease in erythropoietin. Why here the erythropoietin level is decreased? Because what kidney function do? Kidney secretes the erythropoietin. When kidney is failure, chronically it's not producing erythropoietin enough. That's why there is decrease in erythropoietin, and erythropoietin is responsible for RBC formation. So less erythropoietin, less RBC formation, that's why anemia. So anemia here is mean corpuscular volume is normal, MCH, mean corpuscular hemoglobin, is normal, and total iron binding capacity is the normal here. And how to treat this anemia in CKD? We need to treat with erythropoietin replacement, no iron replacement, but only erythropoietin replacement. It's enough for here. Then AE, E is electrolyte abnormality. As you know, what was the work of kidney? Kidney excrete K is potassium, magnesium and hydrogen. When kidney is not working properly, kidney is poor functioning. So what happens here? Potassium not excreted, that's why hyperkalemia. Emia means in blood, there's potassium level increases, magnesium level increases. So how to treat this electrolyte abnormality? We need to restrict the magnesium diet, and if there is hyperkalemia, we need to go for EKG, electrocardiography, and we see the tall T wave. If there is tall T wave, then we need to go for dialysis. And what other electrolytes abnormality? We can say some hormonal. There is decrease in 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol, or we can say calcitriol. This is the active form of vitamin D, and kidney responsible for synthesis of 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol. If there is decrease in active vitamin D, so there is also decrease in calcium, because this helpful in absorption of calcium. But if this is decreases, that's why absorption of calcium decreases. When the calcium is decreased in our body, then there is parathyroid hormone increases, which is responsible for phosphatase increases. So how to treat this condition? We can use in sevelamer, lanthimum. These are the phosphate binder. When they bind with phosphate, so we can treat hyperphosphatemia here, or we can say sinacalcet used to block the parathyroid hormone. If parathyroid hormone, it blocks the inhibit the parathyroid hormone, so there is no hyperphosphatemia occurs here, and there is some intoxication. AEII represent here intoxication. like some intoxications like salicylate, lithium, isopropanol, ethanol, and methanol. They can cause intoxication and renal failure chronic. When there is chronic alcoholic, his kidney goes down, bulking down, GFR decreases due to intoxications. And sometimes there is overload of fluid. We need to do dialysis also here in this stage. When there is not respond with diuretics, I already explained the actual diuretics work to remove the excess fluid of our body. And if that diuretics are failed, so we need to do dialysis here. And in uremia, U-A-E-I-O-U, uremia is pericarditis, encephalitis, nitrogenous waste in the blood. It causes pericarditis, encephalitis. So my dear friend, these are enough about CKD. And if there is high blood pressure in CKD, we can use ACE inhibitor. These are very good inhibitors, very good controller of BP. And we can go for diet restriction like magnesium low diet, potassium low diet. And the fluid of CKD patient can take only 500 ml to 1 liter because it does not cause the overload of fluid. And we need to avoid NSAIDs and aminoglycosides like amikacin. We need to avoid, if there is a gram negative infection, we can use tetracycline. NSAID we need to strictly avoid. We can use paracetamol. If patient suffering from pain, anything, we can go for acetaminophen. That is very much safe. And we can use tramadol, also good result. And if we do transplantation, renal transplantation, what was happened after that, to avoid the rejection of renal transplant, we need to use cyclosporine, tacrolimus and mycophenolate. So my dear friends, I already complete with CKD. If you have any questions, any query, you can ask me. I'm ready to answer you. If you guys, you remember this funda or this formula which I explained you, you really got a great knowledge. You going to get a good knowledge. And if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. Don't forget to subscribe it for new updates. And see here one bell, and you have to click that bell for more new updates. Thank you, my dear friends. Okay, have a good day.